In this video, we state and prove Bézout's lemma and give some definitions and examples. So one definition that will be useful will be the following. Given a and b integers, an expression of the form ma plus nb, where m and n are integers, is called a linear combination of a and b. So then Bézout's lemma, also known as Bézout's identity or Bézout's theorem, is as follows. Let a and b be integers that are not both zero, and let d be the GCD of a and b. Then first, there exist integers m and n such that ma plus nb equals d. In other words, that there is a linear combination of a and b that equals the GCD. And two, every linear combination of a and b is at least a multiple of d. In other words, d divides xa plus yb for all integers x and y. So for example, if a is equal to 21 and b is equal to 15, the GCD of 21 and 15 is 3. And sure enough, we can make a linear combination of 21 and 15 that equals 3, namely 3 times 21 plus negative 4 times 15. But we can also write 3 as negative 2 times 21 plus 3 times 15. So you can see that linear combinations are not unique. In fact, there are infinitely many integers m and n that satisfy 21m plus 15n equals 3. If a is equal to negative 40 and b is equal to 12, the GCD of negative 40 and 12 is 4. I can make whatever linear combination I want to. For example, if I let x equal to 1 and y equal to 5, then xa plus yb equals negative 1, or 1 times negative 40 plus 5 times 12, which is 20. Sure enough, 20 is a multiple of 4, but not equal to 4. So the second part of Bézout's lemma says that whenever I make a linear combination of a and b, I might not get the GCD, but I will get at least a multiple of the GCD. The proof of Bézout's lemma will rely on the construction of a special set. If we look at the set S of all linear combinations of a and b, in other words, S is the set of all ax plus by, where x and y are integers, we will show that the GCD of a and b is an element of this set. In fact, we will show that the GCD of a and b is the smallest positive element of this set S. Just to instantiate this set with a couple of examples, from before, a equals 21 and b equals 15, the set S is the set of all linear combinations of 21 and 15. We can actually check that S consists of all the multiples of 3. In particular, the smallest positive element of S is 3, which happens to be the GCD of 21 and 15. Similarly, if A equals negative 40 and B equals 12, then S would be the set of all linear combinations of negative 40 and 12. We can actually check that S consists of all the multiples of 4. And in particular, the smallest positive element of S is 4, which is the GCD of negative 40 and 12. We're going to show that that always happens. Okay, so let's start the proof. Let A and B be integers that are not both 0, and let D be equal to the GCD of A and B. We can prove part 2 easily. So let's do that first. Recall that part 2 of Bézout's lemma is that every linear combination is a multiple of the GCD. Well, we know that D divides A and D divides B. Thus, A equals DK and B equals DL for some integers K and L. So now let X and Y be arbitrary integers. Then XA plus YB is equal to xdk plus ydl, just by substitution, And then factoring out a d, we can see that d divides xa plus yb. Now for part one. So let S be the set of all linear combinations of A and B, and let little s be the least positive element of S, or in other words, the smallest positive element of the set S. We will show that S is the GCD of A and B. And here's a strategy. We will show that S is a common divisor of A and B, and therefore S is less than or equal to D. And we will show that D is less than or equal to S by showing that D divides S. Since D and S are positive integers, knowing that D divides S is enough to show that D is less than or equal to S. Then we will know that D equals S, and we will be done. Okay, so first we have to show that S divides both A and B. Since S is a member of the set of all linear combinations of A and B, we know that S itself is a linear combination of A and B. So S equals MA plus NB for some integers M and N. Now from the division algorithm, we know that there are integers Q1 and R1 with R1 non-negative and less than S, such that A equals Q1S plus R1. In other words, we can divide A by S and get a quotient and a remainder. If we rewrite, we can use algebra to say that R1 equals A minus Q1S, which is equal to A minus Q1 times MA plus NB. And then we redistribute and we can see that R1 is a linear combination of A and B. Therefore, R1 belongs to the set S. But little s is the smallest positive element of S. And R1 is non-negative and strictly less than S. So R1 must be equal to 0. Therefore, A is actually equal to Q1 times S. And therefore, S divides A. We can repeat this argument to show that S divides B. I encourage you to pause the video and fill in the details yourself to make sure you understand them. Therefore, S is a common divisor of A and B, and therefore S is less than or equal to the GCD of A and B. Now we just have to show that D divides S. Since we have a lot of letters, I've made a little cheat sheet here to show all the notes that we've jotted down. So first of all, D is the GCD of A and B. From part two, we already determined that A is equal to D times K and B is equal to D times L for some integers K and L. I also repeat that here. Capital S is the set of all linear combinations of A and B. Little s, which is equal to MA plus NB, is the smallest positive element of S. And we've just shown that A is equal to Q1 times S, and B is equal to Q2 times S. In other words, S divides A and S divides B. So now to show that D divides S, we can see that S is equal to MA plus NB. Substituting in dk for a and dl for b, we see that s is equal to mdk plus ndl. And then we just have to factor out a d to see that d divides s. Since d and s are positive integers, we know that d is less than or equal to s. Therefore, we have shown that d is equal to s, and part one of Bézout's lemma is proved. One more interesting fact, as a corollary, given A and B integers, The greatest common divisor of a and b is actually the smallest positive linear combination of a and b. And to see this, just note that we showed above that d is the smallest positive element of the set S of all linear combinations of a and b. I hope you found this video helpful.